Air source heat pumps can provide more than 500% of the energy they consume. Given my engineering PhD, I used to be quite skeptical about the energy efficiency of air source heat pumps. I did the math and ended up investing in an air source heating and cooling company. Grab a cup of coffee and let's talk about it. In this video, we'll break down under which circumstances an air source heat pump is worth it for you and debunk common myths. If you're interested in technology's economic viability and climate impact, please subscribe and hit the bell, and let's get started. As a quick reminder, an air source heat pump works like a fridge in reverse in the winter. Heat from the outside air is absorbed by a fluid in the pump. In the summer, it works like an air conditioning unit, transferring heat from inside your home to the outdoor air. There are air source, ground source, and geothermal heat pumps. For more details, you can find links to other videos in the description below and at the end of the video. In a nutshell, geothermal and ground source heat pumps are still more efficient than air source heat pumps due to the constant temperatures underground. However, since there has been a lot of research and development for air source heat pumps in the recent years, their efficiency has become closer and closer to that of geothermal and ground source heat pumps. And the upfront cost is much lower and you don't have to dig a hole into the ground. There are ducted central air source heat pump systems and mini splits. Indoor units can be wall mounted, floor mounted, and ceiling recessed. There has been quite a bit of growth in the air source heat pump market, and it is expected to continue growing. Total air source heat pump shipments in the US have more than doubled from 2012 to 2020. According to the International Energy Agency, almost 180 million heat pumps were used for heating in 2020 as the global stock increased nearly 10% per year over the past 5 years. In the net zero emissions by 2050 scenario, the installed heat pump stock reaches 600 million by 2030. That's great, but are they worth it for you? What about the cost? An air source heat pump costs between $3,500 and $5,200 on average for each indoor handler or zone. Total installation of a central ducted air source heat pump system costs between $10,000 and $19,000. It really depends on the size of your home, how many indoor handlers you need, and if you need duct work, installation, or replacement. A cold climate air source heat pump has a higher upfront cost. However, compared to oil, propane, or electric heating, it can save you a lot of money over time. If installed properly, some models save you 50% on your recurring energy bills, depending on the size of your home. Carbon Switch recently ran an analysis using data from the National Renewable Energy Laboratory. They found that switching from fuel oil to an air source heat pump will save you about $950 per year, and switching from propane will save you about $855 per year. Plus, natural gas and fuel oil retail prices will continue to increase. I recommend getting several quotes. If you want to calculate the break-even and the long-term savings, feel free to have a look at the videos on financial models linked in the description below and at the end of the video. So what about the common myths? One of my favorites is they don't work in cold climates. So there are cold climate air source heat pumps that are specifically designed to work in cold climate. And these heat pumps have a built-in inverter-driven compressor and refrigerant unit that works excellently in icy climates.
In 2019, the Rocky Mountain Institute stated in The Economics of Zero Energy Homes that hundreds of models can operate efficiently in temperatures as low as 5 degrees Fahrenheit or about minus 20 degrees Celsius, with some units performing down to minus 12 degrees Fahrenheit or about minus 24 degrees centigrade. To know if the unit you are looking at is a cold climate or regular air source heat pump, take a look at the Northeast Energy Efficiency Partnership's database of cold climate air source heat pumps linked in the description below.
Another one of my favorite common myths is they are noisy. Most people visualize a modern day heat pump providing the same kind of racket that comes from one of those aging old HVAC systems hanging off the side of the wall of your local fish and chip shop. Nothing could be further from the truth. The latest range of outdoor fan units are superbly acoustically engineered machines aimed at making the unit whisper quietly.
One thing that actually dawned on me when someone had mentioned it, and I said, look, we've got videos online and you can check out whether or not, you know, these heat pumps are loud. I said, well, how do we tell really though, because of the quality of the microphone? So it got me thinking a little bit, how could I do this better for kind of just to incorporate and tell you guys, you know, how quiet this is. So at the moment, obviously, you can hear me loud and clear. And actually the camera at the minute is sat on top of the heat pump. I'm just going to show you quickly.
While it can be admittedly a bit tricky to quantify the noise, most units are virtually inaudible from 5 meters away, and even the closest neighbors will not hear them. Myth number three, exhaust heat pumps don't work in old houses, or they don't work with radiators.
And the first thing we always start with is, how well insulated is your property?
Okay.
What are we heating? Once we understand what we're heating, then we can determine how much, what size heat pump we need and how much energy we need. And the way to get the best COP from a heat pump is to design a system that can operate at a low flow temperature. Okay, so when you think of a new build, it's a well-protected shell of a house. It's going to hold its heat really well. What we put in a new build, because we're building the house ourselves, is underfloor heating. Yeah, it's a massive radiator on the floor, which allows us to run the heat pump at a really low flow temperature because it's such a big surface area. If we don't want underfloor, that's absolutely fine too. They'll work really well with radiators, but you just have to slightly oversize your radiators so that you can operate it at a lower flow temperature.
Despite the great potential of air source heat pumps, you will come across a few bad reviews online. In more than 90% of these cases, the installer made a mistake. It is crucial to have a good installer for the safety, comfort in your home, as well as the long-term savings. A good installer can get really great results with an okay unit, but a bad installer can ruin the latest, best, most advanced technology.
This is the whole thing with the whole industry. Heating engineers will be disappointed with their performance and how happy their customers are if they don't learn about system design before installing them. You have to learn about system design and how to get the maximum COP. The COP that he's talking about. You can't just go and plonk it on the wall like you with a gas boiler and cross your fingers, because they just don't work the same. The point is, it's not the heat pump that's the variable, it's the installer and the knowledge in the installer.
Okay, but how do I find a good installer?
There's a post called 8 Things to Know About Switching from Gas or Oil to an Air Source Heat Pump. It's linked in the description below. Personally, I knocked out the installers who were without a working or relevant website, seemed to be single person operation rather than a team, only worked with one manufacturer, or appeared to be general plumbers trying their hands at installations. Some of the best installers will be so much in demand that they might not be able to start a project for months. During my calls, even the busy installers found time to give useful advice and were clearly enthused being in this business.
Alright, so if your installer is not providing you with excellent service, that's not an issue of the system. So what are the good reviews that I've found? This one's from a family in Massachusetts. Again, I'll link the article in the description below. They say heat pumps are great, they're not noisy, they're fantastic, and they heat up the rooms really quickly. This one-year review says that the heat pump was an excellent decision for their household. It has worked out better on every level than gas, including cost. The unit is very quiet and makes less noise than a gas boiler. In summary, they love their heat pump. It's cheaper, cleaner, quieter, and easier to maintain. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and see you in the next video. Bye!